Okay, today I'm going to start with this sermon.
今天我们会用这个正道来开始。
Now, if you walk into any customer service counter, it is not uncommon to spot the display of what we call the customer service pledge.
当你走到任何一个客服的时候，你会看到很容易就看到客户服务的这个承诺的牌子或者是展示。
For example, the PDRM would say that their piagam pelanggan will strive to make sure customers are served within 15 minutes at the main counter after the number is taken. Or any complaint that is lodged will be attended within 7 working days, and so on.
或者是所收到的投诉呢，都会在七天以内得到处理。
Now, similarly, in the Assemblies of God, the Royal Rangers, if you are one, used to have a Rangers Pledge.
同样的，在神召会里的这个 Royal Rangers 皇家童子军呢，如果你也是其中一个，也有一个这样子的一个诺言。
It says, with God's help, I will do my best to serve God, my church, and my fellow men, to live by the Rangers Code, and to make the Golden Rule my daily rule.
是这样讲的，就是在上帝的帮助下，我将尽我所能侍奉上帝和我的同伴，按照守则生活，并且以这个法则为我的日常规则。
By and large, a pledge is a set of ideals or core values an organization hopes to maintain in its operation and dealings.
总体来说，承诺就是一个组织希望维持其运作的一套理想或核心价值观。
It reflects the highest uncompromising principle that should last for a long time.
它反映出最高和不妥协的原则。
In today's scripture that we're going to read, we will read about an identical idea of a pledge.
今天的经文里，我们将会看类似的经文。
We're going to look at Psalm 101.
我们会从诗篇101篇来看。
Okay, let me share screen so that you can see, or if you have the Bible with you, you can turn to the Bible as well.
让我来share screen 给你们看，如果你有圣经，你可以打开你的圣经。
Psalm 101 says this. I'm going to, for sake of time, we're going to read in English only. The rest of you can look at your own translation.
因为时间的缘故，我将会以英文来到读而已。
I will sing of steadfast love and justice to you, O Lord. I will make music. I will ponder the way that is blameless. Oh, when will you come to me? I will walk with integrity of heart within my house.I will not set before my eyes anything that is worthless. I hate the work of those who fall away. It shall not cling to me. A perverse heart shall be far from me. I will know nothing of evil. Whoever slanders his neighbor secretly, I will destroy. Whoever has a haughty look and an arrogant heart, I will not endure. I will look with favor on the faithful in the land, that they may dwell with me.He who walks in the way that is blameless shall minister to me. No one who practices deceit shall dwell in my house. No one who utters lies shall continue before my eyes. Morning by morning, I will destroy all the wicked in the land, cutting off all the evildoers from the city of God. Let us pray. Father, this morning we come before you. We ask that you may come and speak your word to us.
我们祷告，祈求你来对我们说话。
Especially this last week of the term, we pray that you may use your word, O God, to encourage us.
特别在这个期末的这最后一个周里面，求你用你的话语来到鼓励我们。
Whether those of us who are teaching or whether those of us who are learning, Lord, we pray that your word may continue to nourish our soul.
不管是在做教导的，在学习的，主，愿你的话语继续滋润我们的心。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉主耶稣名祷告， Amen.
Amen. Psalm 101 is a transition from the exuberance of previous few psalms, for example, Psalm 100.
这诗篇101篇是从前几篇比较繁荣的这个高昂的这个诗篇的转折。
For example, Psalm 100 is a popular psalm for us to start church services.
比如说诗篇100篇，通常我们聚会开始都会来宣告的。
It says, make a joyful noise to the Lord. Come into his presence with singing. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise.
主在普天下，当向耶和华欢呼，当称谢进入他的门，当赞美进入他的院，当感谢他，称颂他的名。
And indeed, it is uplifting to know that the Lord, who is King, who reigns forever, even in times of trials and troubles.
确实的，这令人兴奋，并且知道神在这个试炼和患难中仍然掌权。
And that the people who are redeemed by the Lord do have a reason to sing and rejoice enthusiastically.
因此呢，被神救赎了的人要热情的来欢呼赞美神。
It is also the same for David when it comes to Psalm 101.
对大卫来说也是一样的，从这个诗篇101篇去看到。
Many people think that by now, David is already anointed as king, most possibly in Bethlehem, but he hasn't taken his proper place yet because Saul is still reigning.
很多人以为大卫在这个时候已经被高为王了，可能是在伯利恒，但是他其实还没有正式的成为那个王，因为扫罗还在位。
And yet, those years of waiting didn't stop David from being amazed by his heavenly king that he couldn't stop singing about the steadfast love and the justice of God.
但是在这个等候的年日里面，大卫并没有因此就停止对天上君王的这个惊叹，他也没有仔细的去歌颂神的爱和神的公义。
And he understands that he did not choose God.But it was God who chose him and appointed him as king in the first place.
他知道说不是他拣选了神，而是神拣选了他，并且高他为王。
And it was the steadfast love, or some people translate as mercy from the word chesed. It was the steadfast love of God that preserved David's life.
那是神坚定的爱，也是有翻译作为怜悯，是保存了大卫的这个性命。
And that God would continue his covenant with his people through David.
神就借着大卫延续他对他子民的那个盟约。
And God removes Saul and raises David up from a lowly shepherd boy to an anointed king.
神呢就除掉了扫罗，并且兴起了这个卑微的牧羊小男孩，到成为一个受膏的君王。
And this is the justice of God.His act of testifying David as the man after his own heart, when David has nothing to offer.
这就是神的公平，这是神的作为，把大卫给他称义，是当大卫没有什么好可以献上给神的时候。
So you can imagine, while the music and the singing is still there, David makes a pledge.
所以你可以想象，当大卫还的音乐和歌声还在的时候，大卫他就许下了一根承诺。
What is the reason for his pledge?
大卫的这个承诺是因为这什么呢？
There's none other than the merciful love and the righteous judgment of God.
他的承诺莫过于就是因为神的怜悯、神的爱以及神的审判。
For us humans, mercy and judgment are so hard to balance.
对我们人类来说，其实怜悯和审判其实是很难衡量的。
But Psalm 89 verse 14 says that God's justice is the foundation of his throne, and his steadfast love to his people endures forever.
但是在诗篇89篇说到神的公义是他宝座的根基，他对他子民的慈爱永远长存。
Before such undeserving mercy that is shown to David, what is an appropriate response to God, no matter how unmatchable it is?
在这所有大卫他接受这个这么不配的怜悯之前，他感觉到多么的不配，但是他应该怎样的给予神对的回应呢？
To David, it is a pledge.A commitment that he will study the way of the Lord.
对大卫来说是一个承诺，是一个他将委身走神道路的承诺。
The way that is blameless, or some people translate as integrity, which is also the word used to describe animal sacrifice when offered upon the Lord on the altar. It must be without blemish or blameless.
是一个完全的道路，也是有人把翻译成正直。这个字也是用来形容做动物献上给神的时候是要无瑕疵，是完全的。
And as if immediately, David becomes aware of his inadequacy.
马上的大卫就意识到他的不完全。
Like how to be blameless when I can't even survive 1 hour without blame or without sin?
他就问他自己，我要怎样成为完全，当我根本不能在一小时以内不犯罪。
And therefore David cried out and said, when will you come to me, O Lord?
大卫就呼求神说，主啊，你几时到我这里来？
He knew that to live a blameless life is not only difficult, but impossible.
他知道要活出一个完全的生命不只是难，甚至是不可能的事。
Unless the Lord abides in him and he in the Lord.
除非神在他里面，他在神的里面。
And it became clear to him, yes, don't talk about ruling a nation first. How about starting with my own life, my own house, my own private life?
他就清楚了，他说，好，我先不谈治理我的国家，而是从我家里，我的个人生活开始。
And like many of us, if you can recall the time when you responded to God's call to full-time ministry, David made resolutions of his pledge.
我想很多人，我们这里很多人回应，神呼召我们进入全职服事是一样的。大卫他许下承诺的时候，也做出了一些决定。It
was a pledge to live blamelessly with the integrity of his heart.
那是一个以公正的心。
And it can be summarized into 5 statements. 3 is concerning self-integrity. The other 2 is about community integrity.
可以总结为5个点，3个是与自身的正直有关，而另外2个是与群体的正直或想要带来的文化有关。
Yeah, or community integrity also can mean the culture that he wants to lead. So starting with verse 3, David says, I will approve no worthlessness or wickedness.
从第三节开始，大卫就说，邪僻的事我都不摆在我眼前。Because
that word worthlessness usually has to do with worshipping of false gods.
因为那个字通常都是来形容拜偶像的事。And
he said, I will not adore any faithlessness or people who betray loyalty.
他说到，我不喜欢背信弃义的人，或者是背叛忠诚的人。And
I will not associate with corrupted or evil persons.
我也不会与污秽和邪恶的人交往。Now,
don't misunderstand David. David is not anti non-Christians, which is quite ridiculous, huh? If you are living in our multicultural country.
但是请不要误会，大卫他是一个反对非基督徒的人。
But David is saying that to have integrity of heart is to be holy, to be set apart for God, to be separated from the worldly values and practices.
但是大卫其实要讲的是，要一个正直的心，就是要成为圣洁，并且为神分别为圣，与世俗的这个价值观分别出来。
And that is exactly why we are to be trained. So that we can tell the difference between light and darkness in the midst of a world that is crooked and rejects God.
这就是为什么我们在这里的原因，就是为了被训练，所以我们可以在这个被扭曲的世界里面，可以分辨出光和暗的分别。And
not only that, look at how David want to lead his community.
不只是这样，你要看大卫他如何带领他的群体。
It says, by allowing no secret slandering of one another.
他说就是不允许暗中毁谤彼此。
It's just like Ziba, you know, the servant of Mephibosheth, which is Jonathan's son. He tried to badmouth his master in front of David.
就像西巴那个米非波设的仆人，也就是约拿单的儿子，他尝试在他的主人说他主人的坏话。
And by accepting no bossiness or lordliness among his community.
再来就是他不接受这个人互相攀比或者是互奴使皮。
The greater son of David, our Lord Jesus, he also says that whoever wants to be great among you must be your servant.
大卫的后裔，也就是我们的主耶稣，他也这样子说：你们中间谁愿为大，就必做你们的用人。
And as you listen to David's word in Psalm 101, notice how the character of God is fleshed out under David's leadership.
你听到大卫这样子说的时候，你可以意识到大卫他彰显了神的这个属性。
And David always desires to conform to the image of his God.
大卫他终日都渴慕彰显出神的形象。
Not only does he hope to practice what he pledged, he will also confront anyone who rebel against that integrity.
他不只是去操练他所承诺的，而且他也会去对抗那些违背正直的人。
You may ask, David, why are you so strict? Why do you need to uphold so high standard?
你问说，大卫，为什么你那么严？为什么你要设立一个这样高的标准？
The answer is simple.
很简单。
Because he trusts that if the Lord who has saved him and chosen him, the Lord will also bring to realization the kingdom that God has covenanted with him.
因为他相信如果神拯救并且拣选了他，将神也一定会在他的国度实现他所立的约定。
And therefore, there will be a realization of David's, the king's pledge.
所以呢，君王也将会实现他的这个承诺。
David's eye will be able to witness the company and service of faithful and blameless people.
大卫的眼目也可以见证到那些忠心服侍的那些完全的人。
And these people will minister in the kingdom and live with him under the same roof.
他们会一起在神的国度里面服侍，也在同一个屋檐下生活。
And David longs to have communion with God's people.
而且大卫他很想与神的子民彼此交通。
If you look at the land is so full of them, and it is characterized by truthfulness.And integrity, something that Malaysians can dream of.
当你看这片土地的时候，他们是充满在这片土地上，并且是有正直、有这个诚实的，是马来西亚人所向往的一个土地。
And morning by morning, the king will eliminate every wicked evildoer.
一早起来，那些君王呢就会消除那些恶人。
Judgment and mercy.Are two sides of the same coin.
审判与怜悯是同一个硬币的两面。
By morning, the justice is executed, and by every morning, God's steadfast love and His mercies are also renewed.
每个早晨，神会执行他的公义。同样的，每个早晨，神坚定的爱与怜悯也是更新的。
And His love is most perfectly shown where His justice is fully satisfied.Where all things are made right.
神的爱就在此彰显，当就是他的公义得到满足，一切的深渊的时候，为什么会这样呢？
Why is it so? Because this is not just the kingdom of David. This is the holy city and the kingdom of the Lord.
因为不是大卫的国，而是主的圣城和神的国。
Now, how can we apply this psalm to our lives today?
那我们要讲运用这篇诗篇在我们的生活当中呢？
First of all, we need to remember that we live blamelessly all because of God's mercy and judgment.
首先我们要记得就是我们可以过完全无瑕疵的生活是因着神的怜悯和公平。
Or in the New Testament sense, because of God's grace and truth in Christ.
或者是新约的说法，就是全凭着上帝在基督里的恩典与真理。
And this is the theme song of this pledge.
这就是整个承诺的主题曲。
Students of BCM, is that your daily song as well?
BCM 的学生们，这是你们每一天的主题曲吗？
So therefore, don't lose your focus on God's call on your life.
所以不要忘记神对你生命的呼召。
Recall the pledge that you made to him. Sing of his mercy and justice. Give your life to serve him.
所以你要回想起你曾经对神许的这个承诺，你要歌唱神的怜悯和公平，并且献上你的生命给神。
Secondly, remember that even King David sinned after he pledged.
第二个要记得，当大卫许了承诺过后，他依然犯罪。
There is only one king from David's line who walks in perfect integrity and reigns in perfect righteousness.
在这个大卫的这个族谱里，只有一个君王行为完全的正直，用完美的公义掌权。
Only when we are united with Christ can we truly walk with integrity of heart and dwell on the Lord's holy hill.
只有当我们与基督联合，才能存正直的心住在神的这个圣山上。
My friends, how is your union and communion with the Lord?
亲爱的朋友，你与主的联合与相交又是如何的呢？
Are you abiding in his word and he in you?
你有住在他里面，他也住在你里面吗？
I'm not talking about just head knowledge, but is there an experiential and transformational fellowship that's going on?
我不是在讲头脑上的知识而已，而是你是否真的有在神那边经历到真实的改变呢？
Or is it you're just going through the motion?
或者是已经变成这个制度化了？
Yes, you may be doing all the duties in your house, but your eyes no longer look with favor on the faithful of the land, and instead you begin to endure sometimes a heart that is swayed away.
没错，你可能在他的家里面进行很多的任务，但是你的眼目不再看这些土地上的忠诚人，而是开始走偏了呢。
Examine your life and see what is hindering you from that sweet communion with the Lord.
来审查自己的生命，看看有什么是拦阻你与主的这个相交呢。
Fly immediately to the Lord for help.So that you may come back to the way of integrity, so that you may be counted worthy to dwell in the city of the Lord.
你要赶快去飞奔，去到主那边，可以回到那个正直的道路上，并且住在他的城里。
And thirdly, maybe you are not really falling away.
第三，可能你真的没有偏离主。
But are you guarding the integrity of your heart?
但是你是否有去把你的正直的心守得好呢？
Are you, you know, deliberate to deal with the little sin here and there?
你有去故意去对付大小的罪吗？
Maybe there's a little secret slander of other people in your thoughts here and there.
可能是有一些小小的在你的头脑里面暗中的毁谤人呢。
Maybe it's your attitude towards sin that is not enough to be called hate.
可能是你对罪的态度还没有那个恨的那个程度。
Maybe you turn away from big sin, but not really destroy small weaknesses.
可能你从大的罪已经回转了，但是没有真正毁灭那些的弱点。
For example, what you allow your eyes to see or your heart to think.
比如说你让你的眼睛在看什么，让你的心在想什么。
You know, Psalm 101 is not just a pledge of good moral behavior.
你要知道诗篇101篇不是要我们许下好的道德行为的承诺而已。
There is what we call the chiasmus in its structure.
我们这里有看到这个交叉式的结构。
Verse 1 and verse 8 are about the Lord's kingdom and ethics. Verse 2 and verse 7 talks about the house. Verse 3 and verse 6 focus on what is set before the eyes.
第一和第八节呢，是讲到关于耶和华和他国的伦理。第二节和第七节是关于到家。第三和第六节说到的是眼睛所看见的。
And verses 4 and 5, which is the crux of the pledge, highlights the heart of men.
第四和第五节呢，也就是这个承诺的这个内核，是强调人的心。
He will not tolerate a perverse and arrogant heart. Why?
他绝不会容忍这个弯曲还有骄傲的心。为什么？
Because out of the heart, or the same word for heart is mind,Out of the mind or the heart springs either integrity or corruption.
这里说到这个，你的心还有你所想的，都是你的用心发出来的。
So the heart of the pledge is the pledge of the heart.
你也知道，承诺的中心也就是全心的承诺。
The heart of a pledge is the pledge of the heart.
承诺的中心就是全心的承诺。
Is your pledge to God a pledge of your heart?
你对神的承诺是否也是全心全意的承诺吗？
If our heart is compromising, then we cannot encourage one another in the household of God to hate sin and love holiness.
如果我们的心怀恶念，就无法互相鼓励神家里的人去讨厌罪，要圣洁。
So repent.Before the Lord comes with his rod of discipline, because he will discipline the one he loves.
所以要悔改，在神趁主还没有回来的时候，我们要为他所爱的去管教。
Remember, it is the kindness of the Lord that leads us to repentance.
你要记得，是因着神的慈爱领导我们回转向他。
And lastly,When we hear about the news of wars, sickness, death, corruption, and fall of great men and women of God surrounding us.
所以我们常常听到有这个战争，有疾病、死亡、贪污，还有神的伟人堕落时。
It is very easy for us to feel defeat, to feel shame, or to feel injustice.
我们真的是会很容易感到挫败，我们觉得很羞愧，我们觉得不公平。
And the problem with this metaverse generation is that we are too quick to deal with injustice our own way.
这元宇宙的这个时代，面对到的问题就是我们太快用自己的聪明去对付那些不公平的事情。
But let us be assured by the word of God today to wait hopefully for the Lord's justice.
但是今天愿神的话再次的肯定你，带着盼望等候主的再来。
The Lord is not slow to fulfill His promise.
神不会延迟他所应许的。
His execution and deliverance will come in the morning.
他的执法和拯救必在每天早晨临到。
And His execution, when His justice comes, it will always be absolute and complete.
他的执法永远是绝对和完整的。
So no matter what, let us not forget the song that David sings.
所以无论任何时候，不要忘记歌唱大卫他歌唱的歌。
To do justice, to love mercy, and to walk obediently with our God.
就是行公义，好怜悯，存谦卑的心。
Just like what Micah says.
就好像这个米迦所说的。
Let the song about how God has saved us through Christ resound again.
让神如何在基督里拯救我们的歌重新奏起。
From the background of our heart to the foreground of our soul.
从我们心里的后台到前台。
Then we may look to Jesus, our King, the author and the finisher of our faith, and be empowered to live blamelessly.And walk in integrity.
这样我们的眼睛就会看着我们的君王主耶稣，也是为我们信心，创始成终的，让我们可以有能力去活出这个无暇的生活。
And to remember the call that God has given to His church, to you and I.
你要去记得神赐给教会的，给我与你和我的这个呼召。
Amen. Let us pray.
我们一起祷告。
Father, we come before your throne.
主，我们来到你的宝座前。
We thank you that it is your love and your justice that have saved us.
我们感恩是你的这个慈爱还有公义拯救了我们。
Your grace and truth that are shown to us through Jesus Christ, your Son.
你的恩典透过主耶稣基督向我们显明。
Therefore, Lord, we bring our heart to you.
所以主啊，我们把我们的心带到你面前。
We desire so strongly to walk in your ways.
我们非常的渴慕来要走在主你的道路上。
But we also realize how inadequate and weak we are.
但是主啊，我们软弱。
But Lord, we look to you. You are the rock of our salvation.
但是主啊，我们仰望你，因为你是我们救恩的这个拯救。
Let your word shine into our hearts so that we may know how to turn to you.
主啊，愿你的话语来光照我们，好叫我们可以回转向你。
And in the things, God, that we do not have full answer to.
主啊，特别是在那些我们没有答案的事情上。
Help us to surrender to your justice and your love.
帮助我们降服在主你的公平之下，还有你的爱之下。
Help us not to do things in our own way and go ahead of you.
让我们不再以我们自己的方式做事，而是来走向你。
That we may listen and follow your lead.
而是我们要聆听，还有跟随你的带领。
Because you are the heavenly king.
因为你是我们天上的君王。
And we long to live in that city that you have made for us.
我们渴慕住在主你为我们建的那个城里。
Help us that in this season, as we go back to our churches to serve you.
主帮助我们在这个季节里面，当我们回到教会里服事的时候。
And especially Easter is coming soon.
特别是复活节要到了。
That we may fix our eyes on Jesus.
让我们把眼目能够聚焦在主耶稣你身上。
The only one who can give us strength and encourage us.
是你这让我们可以有得着力量，可以得着安慰的。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉主耶稣基督的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
And let me end this sharing with a verse from Jude.
让我来到以一个经文来到结束这个的分享。
It says, Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you blameless before the presence of his glory with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory, majesty, dominion, and authority before all time and now and forever. Amen.
是说到那能保守你们不失脚，叫你们无瑕无疵、欢欢喜喜站在他荣耀之前的我们的救主独一的神，愿荣耀、威严、能力、权柄，因我们的主耶稣基督归于他，从万古以前，并现今，直到永永远远。阿门。